How's it going, guys? Artomox here, and today I'm bringing you a Kayn game. This is gonna be a pretty interesting one, I'm not gonna lie. I wanted to go blue Kayn this game. I definitely did want to go blue Kayn, and then I picked the runes to go blue. And then as I saw the teams, I was like, wait, Set is melee, Vi is melee, Sylas is melee. And then Teemo might be AD carry or top, and then Karth is gonna be somewhere. So at the end of the day, most of the people that I'm going to be fighting are melee. So I knew that in terms of transforming, it's going to be really tough. So obviously, I did not know what to expect. I was just defaulting to bottom because there, since I know that Vi is going to be jungle, I know that either Teemo or Karthus are going to go bot lane. So I just want to focus on them, see if I can get enough blue orbs. But at the end of the day, you know, spoiler alert, I ended up going red. And it was a little bit unlucky, I'm not gonna lie. You know, going red with these runes is kind of awkward, but as you guys can see, this is not gonna hinder me from actually carrying this game. And at the end of the day, it's gonna be all about the gameplay. I feel like this game is really good in terms of the mid game. This is one of those games where it's like get advantage, win lane, win game. So it's gonna be really easy for you two guys, for you guys to see it. Obviously, charts and runes are at the end of the video. And let me know if you guys like this type of content again, even though it's basically the same content over and over and over, just with different champions. You know, I would be pretty happy if you guys got me some form of recommendations. I was thinking about trying out Evelynn. I don't know what you guys think about that. Just let me know in the comments. So yeah, I'm playing Kayn this time. I'm already full cleared because why not? I'm just going to go ahead and try to take the Scuttlecrab. But then as I'm doing that, I see the enemy bot lane or the bot lane just kind of fighting. It's like, okay, you know, might as well just go ahead and take a slice of this. Be able to push this wave, and then after that go to the Scuttlecrab. Because at the end of the day, you know, efficiency, I've already full cleared, you know, look at how Vi tried to check out my jungle, but then there was nothing. And then right here, I definitely wanted to fight the Sylas, but then the fist was kind of slow, but then hey, you know, I get my Dark Harvest stack, you know, I'm actually very happy about that. And then I see the Vi slowly, but then she tries to fight me, I dodge her Q, which is basically the main thing, and then you know, the fist kind of wants to fight. I definitely want to fight too, obviously, because we're stronger. But then Teemo just leaves me, you know, dry. You know, leaves me hanging there. And it's like, oh, okay. Then, you know, whatever. Could have been an easy double kill. But again, like, I'm not too worried about that. And I can just do my own thing still. Obviously, this Vi was hanging up until one point, guys. And this is the main difference. This Vi was platinum player. And I'm not gonna lie. She was doing too bad up until a point, which is basically what happens every single time, right? You know, when you're the lower elos, it's basically you have no clue and then you don't know how to follow the patterns. And then right here, Vi is going bot lane, and immediately I'm gonna go rush into her jungle, see if there's anything I can get. Obviously her raptors are up, her crux are up, and she's gonna go for dragon, which I'm fine with, because at the end of the day, you know, ocean soul, it's okay, it's good for laning phase and stuff, but at the end of the day, you know, one ocean soul is not going to make a huge, huge, huge difference. So yeah, right here, I want to go for Teemo, see if there's any position that I can get my blue form. And at the end of the day, you know, I kill the Teemo, I run away. I'm going to go ahead and take the farm because I know that it's going to be a hassle for me to try to kill the Sylas. And then immediately I'm going to see if I can get my blue buff. And after that, I think, or I hope I'm going to be backing. If not, then I'm just going to be, you know, clearing. Obviously, since the farm is a little bit wacky because of the pathing, right? You know, I went from wolves into checking out her raptors and Krugs, even though I got a kill, and then after that I'm gonna do my Krugs. So my camps are a little bit wacky in a sense because I took my Grump and stuff, but then notice the pattern where my Grump is spawning, my wolf is spawning, I took my raptors, and then the next camp is gonna be Krugs, so at the end of the day it's still smooth sailing. So obviously right here, I'm going to see if I can get the Karthus because they're being a little bit too aggressive. I tried to get the orbs, but then, you know, sadly, I got the red form. And I was like, you know what? All right, I'm going to go the red form. I'm going to go Duskblade. I'm not going to lie, guys. I definitely wanted to go for the full lethality build. I wanted to go like Edge of Night, Duskblade, Edge of Night. Even though after I got the Duskblade, I was like, wait, I think Eclipse would have been way better. But then again, I just like the ability haste. I like the invisibility after you kill someone, which gives you an outplay potential. So I don't know, I just defaulted back into it and then just picked it up, especially because they have no tanks, right? So obviously I'm gonna be adapting a little bit better this time. I'm gonna go for the Black Cleaver next, and then Sterix, and then I'm gonna try to get the Edge of Night, because but I think the game ends before that. And trust me, pro tip, what am I saying? Spoiler alert, they FF. I mean, they don't FF, we just end it. So yeah, right here, obviously, I'm gonna full clear because there's nothing going on the map. I could kill everyone at this point. I'm just feeling like a god. I just feel way strong. You know, look at this Vi. I'm gonna be able to kill her. All I have to do is just dodge her Q, and that's it. Thank you very much for the free kill. I'm gonna check out her Raptors. I'm gonna check out, you know, her Grump, but then bot lane starts fighting, and it's like, okay, you know, I definitely wanna join that because I am huge. So I'm just gonna go ahead, kill the set. After that, try to participate on the Karthus kill. And after that, it's like, you know what? I could definitely do Dragon here, but notice how it's on cooldown. Since it's in some cooldown, I just don't want to rush it, right? I'm just going to take it easy. Hey, you know, I'm just going to take a couple platings, see if there's, you know, chicken minions that I can get, see if I can kill them on their comeback. So yeah, now, even though I have a lot of gold, since I'm so far ahead, I just can feel that we can fight this. I know Sai is backing, and look at this, you know, Vi wants to go in on me, but I am not afraid. I am not afraid. I feel like I'm just way too strong. Look at Silas half HP. I'm just immediately going to commit to it, which turns the fight into a 3v3 mid lane support in me. And then, you know, Fizz throws it in. And again, guys, I came here for Dragon. I didn't come here to fight. I just want the Dragon. So I just take the Dragon and immediately rotate. Obviously, let's see if I can get a couple platings over here too, which is going to amp up my gold by a lot, you know, 160, 160 more. Huge gold. And then right here, I'm gonna see if I can kill this guy. Obviously, I'm not gonna lie, Dark Harvest helped me a lot this game. Even though I don't feel like it's the best rune, obviously you go Conquerors with her Kayn, but bro, this build felt good. I was like going in and didn't even care. So yeah, at 14 minutes, I've already got my Duskblade, I've already got Black Cleaver, and then it's just gonna be pain for them. It's 14 minutes, plates are going down, and at this point I'm just thinking, okay, you know, it's time to start going for objectives. And what's the easier one I can get? You know, Camille just died, so I'm gonna get my topside jungle. And remember, I took it from the inside to the outside just because I had plans of actually going doing something right here. I was gonna ulti, but at the end of the day, you know, there's nothing. I didn't have to, I'm just way too strong, and then I'm just gonna push. A lot of players would get mad about this, but then again, my main thought process is getting that tower. So I'm gonna see whatever I can steal. Obviously, if you see the red was up, so I'm just gonna go ahead and take it. And then Camille kind of gets into trouble, but I'm just gonna go ahead and save her. And then, you know, I'm gonna dodge everything. Boom, thank you very much. For some reason, Camille flashed forwards. But it's like, okay, you know, that's not gonna take me away from actually getting the tower. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and push this wave and get the tower. Remember, guys, what I came here for, to make a play top. Obviously, Teemo comes in and defend, and this is basically what I mean, guys. You need to push your lead. Notice how easy it's gonna be for me to kill this guy. Obviously, I'm gonna make sure that the minions come first because I don't want them to, you know, I just don't want to dry dive. And I'm just gonna go ahead and kill him, get the tower, which is basically what I came for. I'm gonna push this wave because now, since I know that Vi is bottom, I know Silas bottom, and then I know that Teemo's dead, I'm just gonna go ahead and grab up this Herald. I know it's safe. There's no one who's gonna be able to contest me about on it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take it. And this Herald is gonna help me snowball because it's gonna help me get every single other objective that I want to. And yes, I gave the first Herald, guys. I gave away the first Dragon. I made a couple ganks happen. I got really, really strong. And then that's just gonna be it. This is just gonna be me in terms of mid game to play and abuse the advantage that I've already got. Notice how I'm basically, you know, 4 levels ahead of Set, two levels ahead of the Vi, 3 levels ahead of the Silas, 4 levels ahead of the Karthus, and 3 levels ahead of the Teemo. So at the end of the day, there's no one is going to be able to just contest me on anything. So I find Set, which is going to be the first defender of the tower. Obviously, this was more of a free killie, a freebie, because at the end of the day, the wave is not pushed, and this was the wrong way to do it. But, you know, it was free. I have the Herald, so I'm not too worried about that. I'm just going to go ahead and push now. And notice, guys, my whole team is fighting mid lane. And I don't care about that. I don't care that the enemy team is fighting mid lane. I push the wave. I'm about to make a play. I just killed the Karthus. I just killed the Vi. And now I'm going to go ahead and throw the Herald on the bot lane because no one's going to be able to stop me. So I'm just going to wait for my wave here. You know, Fizz has other ideas, but it's all right. I could have definitely taken this tower before taking Herald, so I'm just going to go ahead and do it. And now I'm gonna throw Herald to try to get the inhib. You know, Vi tries to stop me, immediately just go ahead and kill her. Thank you very much. Silas tries to stop me. There's nothing you're gonna be able to do, my good sir. You're 5 levels down on me. Right here, I'm not gonna lie, I try to W, but then there's no shot. And then this guy tries to defend me too. Obviously, this is why mechanics are important. You guys need to know how to play these situations. Notice exhaust, I wait out for the exhaust and then re-engage. This is how you play the situations. This is how you snowball. This is why the mechanics are so important. And this is how you're going to be able to win lane and win game. So yeah, that was the game. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what you guys want me to play next. And as always, stay healthy, drink lots of water, and have fun on the rift, guys. See you in the next video.